YouTube, so I'm going to make a favorite products of 2011 video, and I'm going to jump right in there and start out with face products. My first favorite face product is this Makeup Forever HD Primer, and this is the green one for color correcting for redness, and I love this. It doesn't break me out. For a while, I really liked Smashbox's Photo Finish Primer with the silicone base, and it was like, it felt really cool, but that actually ended up starting to make me really break out, so I have some tubes of that that I gotta get on and swap on Makeup Alley or something. My favorite foundation is Makeup Forever's HD Foundation, and this is in the shade 110. I love this foundation. It's pretty much been the only one that I found that matches my skin. Although I do think that Chanel Vita Lumiere Aqua, whatever, the like rose version of the lightest shade might work for me, so I'm really excited to try that out this year. But so I love Makeup Forever HD foundation. It doesn't have any SPF in it, so it looks good in flash photography, so that's another plus. But it's really just, my boyfriend is dancing the robot over there trying to make me laugh. Motherfucker.
And it worked,
he says. Okay. I love that it has, they say it's like a vacuum packed seal in the pump, so it hasn't oxidized, and I've owned this one for about 3 years. It takes me a long time to go through foundation because I don't wear a ton of foundation because on my day to day I wear tinted moisturizer. Tarte's Amazonian Clay Tinted Moisturizer with SPF 20, the smooth operator. I've had this for like 6 months and I think I'm just down to like right here or something, and I've been using it every single day, so this lasts a really long time. Now I'm wearing tinted moisturizer, I'm not wearing foundation, and I'm wearing my MAC Studio Fix powder over it. So this tinted moisturizer is amazing. I've done a review for it, I'll link it down below because I've already talked people's ears off about it. My favorite face powder is my MAC Studio Fix in NW15. I love this for just by itself. I love it on top of my tinted moisturizer, and if I need a ton of coverage over my foundation. So then my favorite concealer, once again, keeping it in the family, is Makeup Forever HD Concealer, and I use the shade 310, and I love this stuff. It doesn't crease underneath my eyes. It covers blemishes well. I use it like under my eyes, I use it around my nose, I use it on blemishes that I might have on my chin or wherever, so love this concealer. My favorite brushes that I loved in 2011, my first one is the MAC 266, and this met a sad end at one point because I stepped on it and broke it probably about 5 years ago, but it has held up. And I love this for placing shadow on my lash line. I love it for filling in my brows with shadow, and I love it for just all sorts of stuff. I also love my MAC 187. I use this brush every single day for applying my Studio Fix powder to my face. It's a great brush. I don't use it for liquid foundation. I haven't really experimented or tried with it, so. But the MAC artist told my stepmom, like when she was buying a brush, to get this one, so maybe I'll have to give it a try. They were saying like squirt it into the thing and then like dab it on your face and then blend it out, so we'll see. Maybe I'll try it out. And then lastly, the MAC 217, the best brush in the entire world for eye makeup. I love this brush. It kind of does a little bit of everything. I love it for blending, for placing shadow all over the lid, for putting shadow in the crease. It's just an amazing brush, and it's so soft. I love it. Okay, where should I go now? I'll go with blush. My favorite blush, well, it's a tie between two. I love NARS Luster, because I'd never had a blush that was like this color, and when I got this in a swap from Makeup Alley, I just fell in love with it. So I love NARS Luster. It's just so gorgeous. And then my other favorite is MAC's Notable, and I think this was a limited edition. I got this at a CCO, so this is MAC Notable. I absolutely love this blush. I pretty much wore this exclusively for like 3 months. I just love it so much, and I'm kind of sad. I mean, I might try to go to the CCO and see if they have any left over still, because it's so nice and I'll never have it again. Oh well. My favorite highlighting product was the e.l.f. Healthy Glow Bronzing Powder in Luminance. And this only costs like $3, and it is gorgeous. So, perfect little shimmer. My favorite brow product was, or is, MAC Spiked. These brow pencils, I really love these. I used to use Lingering when I had my lighter hair, and I used Spiked when my hair is like this. At one point my hair was so dark, I used Velvetone, which is like the black one. So that was a crazy time. My favorite eyeliners are the Stila Smudge Sticks. I had just gotten one in my Birchbox, and so that was this Lionfish one, but this is Silver Dollar, this is Koi, and this is Damsel. I also have the purple one back in California because my mom got it in her Birchbox and she doesn't want it, so yay. So I love these. As I said in my last favorites video, they will smudge if you want them to, but the second, you know, they set, they're there. My favorite eye brightening product, I guess that can be a category, is this Smashbox iBeam Double Ended Brightener. So that is the side that is for your highlight just on your brow, and then this is the side that goes on your inner rim. In there every single day, brightens up my eyes, and I feel naked without it, really. Like some, it, like when I look at myself, I'm like, something's not right, and then it's, oh yeah, I haven't used this. So, love that. My favorite eyeshadows are, well, it's the Naked palette, basically, because I got this only midway through the year, but then I used it exclusively for so long. Best palette of the year, and I did get the Naked 2 palette, and I love it. I think I love it more than the Naked palette, so any naysayers, just give it a chance. Give it a chance. And then also just kind of like a singular one, I just love Prance Max Mega Metal Eyeshadow. I think this was from some collection because I got it at a CCO, but it is just the most gorgeous all-over lid color. It's basically my everyday makeup, is I just wear this, maybe with something in the crease, probably not, and that's what I'm wearing right now, if you can tell. And I love this color, it's so gorgeous. It's a perfect highlighting color too, but also all over the lid, so love that. 2011 was the year of the lip for me. I became obsessed with lipstick. I think at the beginning of the year, I probably owned 3, 4, 5 lipsticks maybe, and I should do a lipstick collection video because I think I probably have like 30 now. I'm kind of obsessed. My favorite lipsticks are MAC lipsticks and NARS lipsticks, and I thought I would just throw out a couple that have been my faves. Oh, Dubonnet is in my bag. Okay, well, Dubonnet is one. This is Rebel. Rebel is in a gorgeous, gorgeous shade. Doo-doo-t. That is Rebel right there. Another favorite is Afghan Red from NARS. This is a really gorgeous color. There's Afghan Red right there. Barbarella from NARS is gorgeous. Kind of like a sheer peachy-ish coral. And Heatwave, ooh. Heatwave is like what I'm wearing. I'm wearing Lady Danger, which I couldn't put in my 2011 favorites because I just bought it yesterday and I'm absolutely in love with it. But Heatwave is pretty similar, kind of like that bright red-orange color. This is NARS Heatwave. Here is Vegas Volt. So I have been totally in love with like orange-reds, kind of all that kind of color. I remember when I got Vegas Volt seemed like a crazy color, and now it seems kind of like safe compared to what I wear now. So there's Vegas Volt right there. And then lastly, another one that I just love is Girl About Town, and that is this bottom one right there, Girl About Town. So I mean, these are just some of my favorites. I have a million favorites. I'll do a lipstick collection video because I need to share all of my crazy lipstick obsessions with all of you. My favorite nail polishes of 2011. So 2011 was the year that I became obsessed with nail polish, and my collection is kind of embarrassing. I have way too many nail polishes. I'll do a nail polish collection video eventually. Yeah, it's taking up like 2 drawers in my dresser, like little tiny drawers, but still. So my favorite brand of 2011 was Essie, and then I also started to love Butter London as the year progressed. So my favorite colors, just a couple I'll throw out there. Essie's So Psyched. This is a really gorgeous color, a nice kind of muted green. Essie's Chin Chili, gorgeous. Ladylike from their fall collection. Merino Cool. And then these are some great spring summer colors, Tarte Deco and Turquoise and Keiko's. Super gorgeous. And then a Butter London polish that I really love is Wallace. And I was wearing this on my nails in my last video. And now I'll do a favorite perfume. So I have 3 perfumes that I can't really decide between. They're just like my top 3. First one is, I got in a Birchbox a sample, the Atelier Cologne Vanilla Incense perfume. It smells really great. I think there are dupes out there for this perfume because I did smell somebody that smelled just like this, and I asked them what they were wearing, but I couldn't remember what it was now, and that's kind of dumb of me. I should have remembered. But yeah, so I love, absolutely love how this smells, but at the same time, I have my Old Faithful, my Stella by Stella McCartney, which had been my favorite for about 4 years, and I only wore this, so love this perfume. And then also the kind of the twist on the Stella is the Stella Into Peony. It's kind of mirrored too. Can't really tell, but I love this perfume. It smells great. I'm not someone who can describe perfumes, except for saying that it smells nice. So, oh well. And then lastly, when you have all of this makeup, all of this junk on your face and you want to get it off, my favorite product for removing it is Bioderma. And I love how Cami Loves Kiwi describes it as like the micellar solution is like Pac-Man coming and like biting up and swallowing the makeup particles. So, but I should probably link to sometime when she talks about it because she is more eloquent and intelligent than I am at talking about Bioderma. But yeah, so I love Bioderma. It's a micellar solution and you can just use it to cleanse your face. You can use it to remove your makeup, your eye makeup. And it doesn't really have a scent, although sometimes it kind of smells a little gross. I don't know. Like when I was using it like a lot and every single day for like every single time I took off my makeup, I kind of got like sick of the smell of it. But I still love it. I get it for about like $25 or so on Amazon just from some random seller. So Bioderma, love it. Yep. And that is my 2011 favorites video. I hope you enjoyed watching it. And if you made one, leave it as a video response or put some of your favorite items down in the comments and we can talk about them. But yeah, so thanks for watching and have a good day and a good 2012. Bye.